L'Orfeo is a very old opera, 400 years old, written by Monteverdi in 1607. Orfeo is an artist who cannot really live in the moment. He has everything, a beautiful wife, he's gonna get married. And the day of his marriage with Eurydice, she's bitten by a snake and she dies. And this is a moment that everything changes. And he decides not to accept nature and goes to the underworld with his beautiful harp playing to convince the gods to let Eurydice go. The gods give Eurydice back to him under one condition: he cannot look back. He walks out and Eurydice is following him and he looks back. This is the moment that he loses her for the second time. Monique Wagemakers is the director of this opera, and she called to our studio with the question if we were interested to collaborate. And even that we've never done it before, I said immediately yes, right away. And Nanine Linning is a really talented choreographer, and with the three of us we made this concept for this opera. We choose to zoom in on the perspective of Orfeo and how that changes his choices in his life.
Waarom Orfeo? Het staat voor de kracht van de muziek en voor dus kunst en wat kunst teweeg brengt. En ik wist, ik heb kunstenaars nodig om vorm te geven aan deze muziek, aan deze vertelling. Ik zag het werk van Studio Drift en dacht, wow, wat fantastisch, wie zijn deze mensen? Omdat het ook opereert vanuit de natuur, vanuit licht en donker, vanuit leven en dood. Dat zijn allemaal thema's die heel dicht bij Orfeo staan.
I usually work with Ralph on each project, but this time it was me taking the lead. And sometimes he does that for other projects as well. But I still think this opera is really a Drift work. It's completely about the essence of what is in all of our works. Ego is a completely handmade sculpture, woven of 16 kilometers of fluorocarbon, and the production is led by Sarah Michel. And it's an incredible time-consuming process because every single wire has to be tensioned, and when the 8 motors make sure that the block is in a certain shape, then it all has to be aligned and look good, and that this is complete handwork, line per line, it needs to be fixed. We had software developed to move this block, because if you pull with one motor, it transforms in shape, but if the other motors don't move along, you tear the block apart. So we also developed a specific algorithm in order to make that the motors have to do what they have to do on the right moment. Next to that, we have to deal with live music. So we also have a possibility to, on the spot, change the duration of the movements in order to line it up with the music. In the theater performances, Sarah will travel with the opera to all the theaters and be the live puppeteer during the performances. During the rehearsals, Monique and Nanine are in charge. And Nanine is a choreographer with her own dance company, and her dancers are part also of this opera. And I really love her work because she knows how to capture emotion and intensity in her work. And that's what I also try to achieve with what we do. You know, the interaction between Orfeo and the block, it's such a strong, weird connection that the two have together. It's magical. Monique is brilliant in picturing all the aspects together. Even if certain parts are not there yet, she knows what it's going to be. And I found that super hard, and it's so great that she could do that for me. And I had to trust her, and she was right.
Ik had zelfs al in die koude van Genthallen, waar ze heel lang hebben gezeten, en om met het flexblok om alles helemaal precies met elkaar af te stemmen. En de enorme poëtische kracht die vanuit het flexblok gaat, heeft me tot tranen toe diverse keren dat ik dacht, wauw, wat? Ik bedoel, de tranen schieten echt in mijn ogen. Het heeft zo'n enorme poëtische kracht dat, ja.
We chose to call the block Ego. Actually, it comes from the opera, because Orfeo is captured in his own perspective, and that limits him. And basically, his own ego is in his way to succeed in his life. And at the other hand, it also creates big power for him in order to achieve other things. Every frame is limiting. But there's also no possibility to not have a frame. So it also depends on how that ego is shaped, how flexible it is, or how rigid it is. Because if it's rigid, there's only one truth. And if it's flexible, you can move along with what is needed in order to accept certain truths, or accept how life is, or how the world is being built. And I think that is a big difficulty in everybody's life, to be flexible in your vision and be flexible in your perspective. But we have to be flexible, and I like that about ego, that it can be a very rigid block, but it can also completely change. It can be a solution. It's not always the way to go in it, rigid and hard. We have to embrace our fragility and use it.